Hey guys, thanks for watching the Install Pros channel. Today we have Brock here to ceramic coat a wheel. If you're new to our channel, check out the video description below for all the links to the products he uses, and be sure to like and subscribe.
Go ahead and start by cleaning the wheel. Clean it really good, get into all the little nooks and crannies. Make sure you don't leave anything behind. The cleaner, the better. It's all in the prep work. So the more time you take doing a good job cleaning and prepping, the better the end result. On wheels, sometimes it's hard to get in where the lug nuts are. You can poke your finger into the end of the rag and kind of get in there and get all the different angles of the spokes. Make sure you're rotating your rag. As you clean a spot, it's going to get dirty, and so you rotate it like you did there to a cleaner spot and just keep rotating it. If your rag's getting pretty dirty, then you'll want to go ahead and switch your rag out. It's good to clean with isopropyl alcohol and water. That works really well. 50-50 solution or something close to that will work great. When applying ceramic coating to a wheel, you'll want to use a 10H product. That refers to the hardness and the durability of the chemical. You'll want a higher end chemical. There'll be a link to a chemical that we recommend in the description of this video. And when you use a chemical, it will usually come in an aluminum bottle. You'll want to make sure that you keep the lid on that each time that you take the lid off, put it back on, and keep it in a nice cool place. A refrigerator is also recommended after if you have any left. Ceramic coat your wheels when they're new. Occasionally you'll have some you've had for a while and you'll want to polish them and kind of buff them out, and then go ahead and clean them, and then follow this process here of applying the ceramic coating. So you want to apply the ceramic coating, and you wait about 20 to 30 seconds depending on the humidity and the temperature, and then you go ahead and level it. That's what we're doing here now. When you wipe that chemical on, it has a flash time of about, sometimes it can be more like 20 to 40 seconds. You just kind of look at it and you'll see it kind of haze over and flash, and then you go ahead and level it. And so if you were to leave it on there, it would look blotchy and you'd have some kind of different looking spots, high spots and such. So you see him coming along there with the towel and leveling it, and then rotating his towel and leveling it some more. Now here we're applying some more ceramic coating. Go ahead and you want to double up every area that you're doing. So if you look, it's going over it twice there. Okay, and wait for it to flash. The video sped up, so what looks like 5 seconds is probably about 25 seconds. And then go ahead and level it, rotate the rag, level it, rotate the rag, level it. You're not wiping the ceramic coating off. The ceramic coating has a chemical reaction and bonds to the wheel or the surface that it's put on. Once it flashes, part of what's in the chemical solution is water and some silicone and some other things, and that's the part that doesn't necessarily bond to the surface you're putting it on, and that's what you're wiping off and leveling. The chemical itself stays. What you want to do is, when you're applying again, as you're watching him move around here, what he's doing is he's doing some of the areas twice, so he's kind of overlapping, and that's okay. Make sure you don't miss a spot, but you definitely want to overlap your pattern. On a flat surface on a car, you do what's called cross-hatching, so you go up with some motions and then across, back across it, and so on a wheel, you've just got to kind of apply it to a spoke as you're going in the lip in the area, and then kind of come back over it and just make sure that you don't miss any spots. You'll want to use microfiber applicator pads as well as microfiber rags for leveling. There'll be a link to the rags that we recommend that we're using in this video here in the description of this video. As you see there, he went over those spokes in that area about three times on that one, so it doesn't hurt to, especially on wheels where there's a lot of little different areas, nooks and crannies and angles, to just go over it two or three times and make sure you don't miss anything. They switched rags there. So this looks like could possibly be the last section where he meets the one he's on with the first one he started with. And it's a good idea, if you can't remember what spoke you were on, go ahead and just recoat the one you started with. He probably remembers which one it is. So go ahead and just reapply. You can always level it back off with the rag. He's switching rags. So he started with one rag, and the reason why was he would let the chemical flash and then he would level it with a rag. And then he would rotate it to a different spot on that rag and level back over that again. And as he went around the wheel with that same rag and realized that most of that rag had been used to level the ceramic coating, so it had it on it, he went ahead and added the gray rag so he had a dry one to follow that rag with. So when you level the ceramic coating, or what appears to be wiping it off after you apply it, you want to use one, you want to have two rags or one rag and be using the dry surface on the second wipe.
Thanks for watching the Install Pros channel. If you found this video helpful, check out the description below for the links to all the products that he used, and be sure to like and subscribe. Also, we're on social media, so check us out for the latest updates, giveaways, and discounts.